one professor in University of Virginia, and he's a very famous professor called Ian Stevenson, spent his whole life researching reincarnation. He's a very hard-headed scientist, given tremendous credential by his own university as a top scientist, spent his whole life researching reincarnation. Very interesting. Initially what he started was, he said, let me put people into hypnotic regression and say, okay, now go back in time, go back, you are a little baby, now go back, and suddenly the person talks of a different personality. He thought it's a good way to start. But in no time he realized there's not a good way of doing research on reincarnation, because in his surgery there were half a dozen Cleopatras. So they were daydreaming, they were conjuring up their own stories. So this is not suitable research material. He gave it up. But there are some cases of famous people who have been kind of put into hypnotic regression, who have given out fantastic information which fits with facts. But you can do research yourself. So Professor Stevenson stopped researching using hypnotic regression. Then he found something else. He discovered there were lots of young children, normally 3 years old. In fact, the average age according in his research is 39 months, who spontaneously remember or start talking about another life. So the little boy John gets up in the morning, goes to his mommy, says, Mommy, I'm not John, I'm David. And of course he gets a smack. Mommy says, you are John. No, Mommy, I'm not John, I'm David. And by the way, Mommy, I'm married. You're married, you are 3 year old. Yes, I'm married. And Mommy, I've got 3 children. And he gives the names of the children. And of course, Mommy's, you know, bewildered. In most cases, they'll ignore the poor chap. But in many cases, through the university chain, university network, Professor Stevenson finds out. And he'll rush off there, take some translators. Sometimes they talk a different language. Take translators with him, and very studiously, very meticulously, will quiz that youngster again and again. Lots of questions. And that youngster, in a matter-of-fact voice, will give out information about a past life, a different life. And this would be recorded. It's all recorded. Do you know how many case studies this Professor Stevenson has done? You'll be amazed. About 3,000 case studies. That's not a small amount. He spent his whole life researching this. So far, so good. Okay, these youngsters are babbling about another life. Maybe it's true, maybe it's not true, but they're babbling. They're in a very matter of fact voice. But then the next stage of his research is the more interesting part. Sometimes the youngsters talk about a life that was lived only 50, 20, 30 years ago. And they can give the location, they can give tremendous amount of information about their name, their family, the house number, the color of the door in the house, where they were married, how many children they had. They give all this information comes up, even some intimate details that they only discuss with their own wives. They would divulge this information, professor. He would write it down meticulously. Now here the fun begins. Because as these lives were not very, very kind of ancient, suppose they talk about life which was lived 500 years ago, you can't do any research on that. But in many cases, the lives were only 25, 30, 50 years old. You can do tremendous proper research on this because you can dig out. And this is what Professor Stevenson has done meticulously. And this is where the unique information that comes out of his research is. There's a wonderful fit. There's an extremely good fit. In some cases, you know, that he recalls, the youngster would talk about the private conversation he would have with his wife, and the wife is still alive, she's an old lady. And this youngster is taken to that house, and that old woman opens the door and says, the little boy says, oh, my wife! So, no, you're not. Problem. But then the information the youngsters give out, the private conversation, fits. Incredible material. So now, you can see this is not a minor thing. And the further thing Professor Stevenson has done, which is very unique, which the Hindus have never done, is that he said, if an individual is murdered or killed or violently killed, then the place where he was shot or perhaps pierced with a knife or sword or something, the same birthmark appears in the youngster. Now this is, you see, people like empirical evidence, physical evidence, not just babbling, not just subjective interpretation, but physical, materialistic, pure empirical evidence. This is what he has done. In fact, if you go on Google and look at Ian Stevenson, and if you like past life, experiences, and especially birthmarks, there is a video now, clip, about 30-minute clip where he gives a lecture at one of the universities about his findings. You should do that at your own leisure. But the unique feature is this. In some cases, the information is so dramatic. Suppose somebody was shot, one person was shot, and he had, of course, bullet go through this part and come out of the other part. Now, when the bullet goes in, it only leaves a small mark. But when it comes out, it's already scattered. And unusual as you may find it, the birthmarks fitted. There was a small mark in the front and a bigger mark at the back. So all these autopsy reports, all the photographs, everything is available if you just do Google search in Professor Stevenson's lecture. This is, if you like, empirical evidence, birthmarks, physical evidence, not just talk.